I think we'd just carry them all together. We'd be like, we'd carry them together like, we'd be like Shaq and Kobe with the MVP, All-Star MVP, we'd be like fighting over them and stuff, so. Yeah, we just carry him together. We just might let Chuckee carry him. He kind of big. He the biggest one out of us all. So he can carry him.
What up, guys? Ali here, and welcome to Ali Talks Music. Add me on Instagram at Ali Talks Music as well. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Now let's get into the video. Around 2010, Young Money was on the top of the hip-hop genre. They released about 4 albums in 1 year, namely Thank Me Later, Rebirth, Pink Friday, and I'm Not a Human Being, further cementing Young Money's place at the top of the hip-hop game. Despite having an awesome roster of artists, Wayne kept acquiring new talent and added Lil Chuckee to the label around 2010.
It's Lil Chuckee, whoa, wouldn't mind stuff, bro. I can hear him whispering, there
Lil Chuckee's official name is Rashad Chuckee Ballard, and he originates from New Orleans. Lil Chuckee started rapping from a very young age. It was a hobby at first. He would rap for his friends, family, and even did a couple of small shows before he was signed by Lil Wayne. One thing that gave Lil Chuckee headway in his early pursuit of a music career was the love and support his own family gave him whilst growing up. His family noticed that Lil Chuckee strongly desired to be a rapper, and as a result, they pushed him in that direction. When Lil Chuckee signed to Young Money, he couldn't believe that his dreams were finally coming true. He was 9 at the time.
He was hungry
and ready to accept his position in Young Money. It's a blessing being so young in this industry, and for my prestige in the game to be respected is just so cool. Working with Wayne himself is so amazing. A 15-year-old teenager from New Orleans signs with Wayne, signs to a record label that's on top of the world right now. It's just unbelievable. Despite having a record deal with Young Money and being signed to one of the biggest artists in the world, Lil Chuckee's career did not take off, becoming one of the many artists on the label that did not blow up. After his stint on Young Money, Lil Chuckee has remained relatively silent. So the question is, what happened to Lil Chuckee? Lil Chuckee's first encounter with Lil Wayne was in a music video shoot.
Lil Wayne was supposed to be in the video,
and that's something Lil Chuckee was not aware of before he got there. After Lil Wayne noticed the young rapper on the set, he gave Lil Chuckee an audience to rap for him, something that greatly benefited the young rapper. After Lil Chuckee finished his last sentence, when he decided to recruit Chuckee, I met Chopper at a previous concert, and he had seen me dancing on stage, and he was like, I want you to come to my video, and I went to the video. Wayne was featured, so I met Wayne and I rapped for him, and he was impressed and said, I'm gonna work with you. You know, I was still young, so I didn't know what was going on. And I was like, man, this is Wayne. We lost contact until I moved to Atlanta, and he saw me on video. He'd see me on television, and he was like, oh yeah, I definitely got to get back in touch with this guy. Since he had gotten Lil Wayne's full attention and full interest. However, this was not the moment that got him signed.
After that day, he lost contact with Lil Wayne, and it wasn't until Lil Wayne saw Lil Chuckee on television, and it was moving from there.
After Lil Wayne's manager spotted Lil Chuckee in Atlanta, he knew that Lil Chuckee would be a perfect fit for Young Money. They flew Lil Chuckee to Miami after that, and a few months later, Lil Chuckee started making music for Lil Wayne. Once Lil Chuckee got signed to Young Money,
he did a couple of features
and worked with a lot of his label mates.
He appeared on the Young Money compilation where he was featured on 2 tracks,
one of which was the single called Girl I Got You. I'm gonna talk about all of this in a second, but on a side note, there was an incident between Lil Chuckee and Lil Wayne that happened on stage in front of the world to see. While Lil Wayne, Lil Chuckee, and Young Money were on stage, Lil Wayne walked over to Lil Chuckee and punched him in the face.
According to Wayne, he was just playing
and didn't mean anything negative by it. No, I'm not getting rid of Chuckee. I didn't punch him for real. I just played too damn much. But you love it though. Now around 2009, Young Money released their very first compilation album called We Are Young Money. The album was created to put the spotlight on the newest members of the label, with Lil Chuckee appearing on 2 tracks, namely Girl I Got You and Finale. Now, I said this in my What Happened to Little Twist video, but Girl I Got You is one of the cheesiest songs I've ever heard in my life. I personally couldn't play this song for longer than 10 seconds, and it would instantly skip the song whenever it got played. Also, Lil Chuckee's verse on Finale was also super cheesy, and the song would have been great if it only featured Drake, Nicki, and Wayne. Now, Lil Chuckee is just like his boss Lil Wayne. He went hard on his music career and kept producing songs on songs. By the time Lil Chuckee was 16 years old, he had already released 5 mixtapes and worked with many big names like Birdman, Drake, Lil Twist, Nicki Minaj,
Kanye West,
Gutta Gutta, Ludacris, and so on.
When Lil Chuckee was on Young Money, he got along with everybody on his team.
He referred to them as big brothers and big sisters, and defined Young Money as a place where everyone treats everyone with the same respect.
However, after Lil Chuckee left Young Money, his tune changed.
Claiming that Young Money claimed to be a family just for the camera, and were not so close behind closed doors. Look at it like this, Fresh Prince and Bel-Air, they were acting right, and the family on TV, right? But, once the show stops, it's all camera. And after the people done seeing it, they split up. They ain't gotta keep it 100 since the camera ain't always on. That's how it is.
Now after Young Money started falling off,
Lil Chuckee saw the need to move on to a solo career. Before then, there were rumors of Lil Chuckee filing a lawsuit against Birdman. When asked about the situation with Birdman during an interview, Lil Chuckee said the following.
Nah, and I have the time right now.
Thank you, Sway, for giving me the time to deny and let everybody know that it ain't true. I don't know where the rumor comes from. Bullshit, you know what I'm saying? I don't think my name and Cash Money name should be defamed in that kind of manner. You know what I'm saying? During an interview with Sway around 2014, he also broke the news of no longer being a part of Young Money and said the following. Nah, I got my clearance. Had to handle business. You know what I'm saying? It's business. No feeling can get caught up in it. Nothing like, what's going on in there? I've got history to make. Now in my opinion, one of the major problems Lil Chuckee faced on Young Money was the way he was marketed and branded. In a way, Lil Chuckee was marketed as a replacement for Lil Wayne. He undeniably sounds, raps, and almost looks like Lil Wayne, putting him in a very precarious position. Because at the end of the day, there can only be one Lil Wayne. Now I do understand what Young Money was trying to do. They wanted each artist on Young Money to cover a certain demographic, and Lil Chuckee was supposed to represent the younger generation along with Lil Twist. However,
it didn't work because Lil Chuckee and Lil Twist don't have that thing.
You know, they don't have the ability to make songs that the general public really gravitates towards. Another issue Lil Chuckee faced was his inability to produce an album. Whenever an artist isn't able to release an official studio album, that's not a very good look. It usually happens because that artist doesn't have enough buzz for the label to even think about investing money in their project. This applies to Lil Chuckee. Even though Wayne kept pushing Lil Chuckee into the spotlight, the young rapper failed to capture the public the way Young Money hoped he would,
pushing his album to the back of the label's priority list.
Now it's safe to say that Lil Chuckee was granted the opportunity of a lifetime when he got signed to Lil Wayne. He was able to put out music on the biggest label at the time, and was able to release songs to the general public even before he finished high school. Lil Chuckee has a lot to be grateful for. But did he capitalize on that time with Lil Wayne and Young Money? He did, but not so much.
I'm recording this audio on October 1st, 2021,
and it just so happens to be Lil Chuckee's 26th birthday. But as of late, it appears like Lil Chuckee is not making much noise. After he left Young Money, he released yet another mixtape called Overdue, one that signified his transition from commercial artist to indie. The mixtape was also a transition from him being a kid to a grown adult. The mixtape was released around 2014. After dropping the mixtape, Lil Chuckee seemingly vanished from the music scene. I suppose that happens when you're not backed by a major label like Young Money.
Now around 2020,
Lil Chuckee announced the potential release of new music.
He had a track called Courtway that was supposed to come out, and when it actually did come out,
it really didn't make much noise. Lil Chuckee used the track to talk about street life and released it through his own Hustling Creatures imprint. Now the fact that Lil Chuckee has his own imprint is a good thing. He's pushing, he's making moves. However, if you ask me, he should have done this about 10 years ago. Till now, Lil Chuckee is not very visible in the music scene. He claims to be working on new music behind the scenes, but doesn't seem to be dropping music for his core fanbase. That's if he even has a fanbase to begin with. In conclusion, Lil Chuckee gained a lot from his affiliation with Wayne. He became a global artist and was able to spread his music to the world. And this is something that not many artists have achieved. With that being said, Lil Chuckee just didn't have any bars. None whatsoever. Lil Chuckee gets about 4,000 monthly listeners on Spotify, and his most popular songs on the platform are Da Wap, Yo Yo, Text Me, Courtway, and Semi.
You lose friends with that. You lose close ones. but you go and chase something that's greater. And also on the other side, it was those that wanted more out of it. So I was one of those that was able to balance it on my Libra scale. To know where I come from, never forget it, but also understand that the sky's the limit. I just gotta go and see what it is that I have to do in order to get it and go and get it done. Young Money and Family, Drake is doing good, Nicki is doing good, Tiger is doing good, Wayne will forever do good. He, you know, he put me on, he put me in the position in these bricks. A lot of stories before me while I was roaming here and after I left. But now it's those, it's what we look like right now. YM, I'm forever YM.
That's it for me, man. It's your boy Ali. What happened to Lil Chuckee in your opinion? Let me know down below. If you have a video request, be sure to let me know as well. New Happen 2 video dropping next week. Also add me on Instagram at AliTalksMusic. Till next time, peace.